Hello students, in this video we are going to see basic system properties, invertibility and inverse system. So basically, definition of invertibility is this: system should give you distinct outputs for distinct inputs. What is the meaning of this? Let's represent this diagrammatically. So suppose a signal is there, given to one continuous time system to get an output. Let's consider x of t, an input, passes through a continuous time system to get output, which I will represent as, say, WT, and this output I'm passing through one more system. WT, I can say output from the system, which we can say it's YT also. So YT will drive one more system to give another output. This time the system should take care that whatever the input it will give, it should able to produce the same input as it is, meaning after passing y of t through this inverse system, we should able to get x of t. So what is happening for one kind of input x of t? I pass through a system, I got some intermediate output that should be passed through inverse system to get a signal itself. So this will be the output, nothing but the input. So I can say after passing through this system, original input is gathered. So what happens sometimes, we have one particular signal, and let's take an example where I'm having a signal which is a continuous time, and that is passed through A to D converter, so that it will be converted into a digital. And that we pass through some digital process. DSP, digital signal process. And that whatever signal we get, in the end, we should able to reproduce the same signal which has passed over here, which is x of t. But because I need to use a DSP for a better efficiency and accuracy, I convert that into digital signal through this block. So DSP will perform all the necessary procedures on the digital signal, but in the end I should able to get a same continuous input signal. So over here I need to use DAC, which will convert a process signal. So what we want in the end, it should give us a signal. which is same or correlated with the input signal only. So this can be considered as a system with the inverse system. Let's see one more example. Let's mathematically consider an example of y of t as 2x of t. Now, x of t is the signal passed through a system to get y of t, and that y of t need to be passed through inverse system in order to reproduce x of t. I repeat, x of t is the input signal passed through the system. So what system is going to do? System is simply going to multiply the input signal. So we'll get a y of t like this. And this y of t need to be passed through one more system, which will give the signal wt, which should be half y of t. So if I do this, in the end, wt will be half and y of t is 2x of t. 2 to get cancelled, in the end, wt will reproduce x of t. So I can consider this system will be having an invertibility property. Let's take one more example in discrete time domain. So suppose the system is like this. Y of n is summation k from minus infinity to infinity x of k. So logic is this: x of n is passed through the system, which will give you y of n, and that need to be passed through one more system in order to reproduce a original signal x of n. I repeat, x of n is the signal passed through this system. The job of the system is to get this value, summation ranging from minus infinity to infinity x of k. So this will give you y of n, and now I need to produce this signal once again, which can be done simply by having a system in place which will do this: y of n minus y of n minus 1. So if you do this, in the end, we will get a Wn which is equal to x of n. So the given system is an inverse system. Let's take an example where system will not be considered as an inverse. So example is this: y of t equal to x square t. So now what will happen? X of t is there, passed through the system, which will square the signal. So x of t is the input signal. Job of the system is to squaring the signal. Now from this, if I have to get an original signal, I need to do the square root. So system will have wt as root of phi of t. So the problem over here is this root of y of t will give you two signals, because root of any number will always give you plus and minus signals. So over here we'll get one signal, which is x of t, and another signal is minus x of t. So the problem is that now we are getting two outputs. Hence I can say we are not getting a distinct output for a distinct input in this case. Hence this system cannot be considered as inverse system. So the definition of inverse system is that for a distinct input, I should get a distinct output. This is what a invertibility and inverse system. Thank you.